In a previous video, we described the radial bearing built with permanent magnets. The repulsive magnetic forces between permanent magnets compensate the rotor weight and make the shaft levitate. In this video, we bring a machine that applies a similar suspension principle. We are going to describe a bearingless motor with active control along a single axis. In other words, it is an electric machine that combines passive stabilization and active regulation as levitation techniques. First, we should name properly the directions in which the rotor can move. If the shaft rotates around the z-axis like shown in the figure, displacement along the z-axis is called axial or thrust movement. Displacement in a plane that is normal to the z-axis is called radial movement. Inclination of the rotating shaft is called tilting. Now, let us take a look at the machine. The rotor shaft is the object that must be levitated. There are two structures positioned at opposite ends of the machine. These are the permanent magnet radial bearings. They consist of pairs of concentric ring-shaped permanent magnets. The ones attached to the rotor mutually repel the ones attached to the stator. When the rotor and stator are centered in the radial direction, repulsive forces nullify each other. If the rotor moves along the radial direction, the repulsive forces increase on the side that is closer to the stator, pushing the shaft back to the center position and stabilizing the radial direction. When there are radial bearings in opposite ends of the rotor shaft, they also prevent rotor tilting. This permanent magnet configuration also generates an unstable force along the axial direction. If the rotor is displaced along the z-axis, the repulsive force pushes the shaft farther away from the center. In this moment, the viewer might think, well, if this radial magnetic bearing stabilizes the radial direction, but destabilizes the thrust direction, we can compensate it with another permanent magnet for thrust stabilization. However, this is not possible. It is not possible to find a stable balance position using only permanent magnets. If you stabilize one direction with permanent magnets, you end up destabilizing a different direction. In order to achieve full magnetic levitation, we need to employ additional suspension techniques, like active regulation of magnetic field, for example. Let us look again at our machine. There are two permanent magnets attached to the rotor between the radial permanent magnet bearings that were previously mentioned. One is in the upper side, and another one is in the lower side. The magnetic field generated by these permanent magnets flow into the iron core in the stator side. The magnetic field from the permanent magnets interacts with the field generated by the stator currents. Owing to this specific configuration, the magnetic field is either reinforced in the upper side and weakened in the lower side of the stator teeth, or it is reinforced in the lower side and weakened in the upper side, according to the current direction. This difference in magnetic field distribution results in an electromagnetic force that pushes the rotor along the axial direction. By regulating the stator current, it is possible to generate a suspension force that pushes the rotor back to the center, compensating the unstable force by the permanent magnet radial bearings. The same currents can be used to generate motor torque. Now, let us see the motor in action. First, we turn on the levitation control. Next, we start rotating the machine. If not for the noise, it would be very hard to notice that the rotor is even moving. Now, we attach a fan to the rotor tip. This will allow us to see the movement easier. This machine reaches high rotational speeds up to 30,000 RPM. Thank you for watching this video. Please check our other videos on magnetic levitation.